brothers and sisters, we still in the explanation of Surah An-Nahl. And it's very important to know that this surah and with the other chapters of the Quran, with the other surah of the Quran, these was the subject that the companion of a Prophet Muhammad study, and the companion of a Prophet Muhammad graduate from, and the companion of a Prophet Muhammad build the most important nation in the human history. Only this is was their studying, this is was their books, this is was their knowledge. And with the knowledge of the heaven and the knowledge of the connection with Allah, they did what they did. We reach to the ayah number 70 in Surah An-Nahl. Allah Azza wa Jal said in this ayah, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم والله خلقكم ثم يتوفاكم ومنكم من يرد إلى أرذل العمر لكي لا يعلم من بعد علم شيئا. Allah has created you and then He takes you back. And among you, there is some of you will go and will be in the worst parts of the age. أرذل العمر. أرذل العمر is the worst part of the age. So they know nothing after having knowledge. Surely Allah, the all-knowing, the all-powerful. And this ayat give us great evidence, give us great clarifying about who created everything. It's a very big question. It's a very important question. Who is created everything in magnificent way, in perfect way, in very beautiful way? Allah created you. Allah created you. Allah created the heaven. Allah created the planets. Allah created the animals. Allah created the vegetable and the fruits. And this is very important question in the human life nowadays. We make just the theories here and there. Everything from the science is accepted when it's a truth. But when it is imagination, when it is just talking, when it is just to put something, just to prove that Allah is not exist, this is the satanic theory. This is satanic knowledge. This is satanic science. The creation of Allah is very clear. There is no proof in the that it is night. If you see the night, you see the darkness, and you need a proof. Proof for what? Proof for what? And this is the main thing when someone need proof that Allah exists. Allah said, Allah created you. And not that. And Allah challenging you to create life. Till now, we do airplanes, we do computers, we manufacture many nice things, but we cannot create one life cell. We cannot create one life cell. So Allah created us. ثم يتوفاكم. Then He will bring us to the point of the death. Then He will take us back. Then He will take us into death. ثم يتوفاكم. And if you look to this ayah, it's an amazing ayah, as we said last week, that Allah created us, then He take us back. So there is something missing. Where is our life? Where is al-hayatu dunya? Allah didn't mention here. He mentioned the creation and then mentioned the death. Where is al-hayatu dunya? Yes, why Allah didn't mention it? Allah didn't mention it because it's n to zero if you compare it with the other stages of our life. If you compare it to al-barzakh, if you compare it to the day of judgment, if you compare it to akhirah, to live forever in Jannah or in Nar, if you compare it between the other stages in our life, it will end to zero. We cannot say it equals zero. It end to zero because it has a time. How much is small, is, but it ends to zero. So this is our dunya. For this reason, Allah didn't mention it. He said, Allah created you, and then Allah will take you back. Allah will bring you to the point of the death. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was making dua exactly the same meaning of the ayah. And this is the real sunnah of Rasulullah. This is the real ahadith of Rasulullah, which coming completely with the meaning of the Quran, with full harmony between the hadith and the Quran. كان صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول, رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم said, اللهم أنت خلقتني, oh my lord, you created my soul, اللهم أنت خلقت نفسي, and you will fulfill it, and you will bring it to death, وأنت توفاها لك مماتها, her death for you, her life for you. So please, in أحييتها فاحفظها. I ask you, if you give life to it, please protect it. وإن أمتها فاغفر لها. And if you put it to death, then please forgive it. Oh God, I ask you for well being. اللهم إني أسألك العافية. The well being. اللهم إني أسألك العافية. So, for this reason, Allah created us, and Allah who put us to the point of the death, who will take us back, and who he decided when that will be. No one knows except Allah. وَمِنْكُمْ مَنْ يُرَدُّ إِلَىٰ أَرْذَلِ الْعُمْرِ. And now, Allah didn't mention the dunya except one stage of our life. And this stage is very, very important. Some of you will go back to the worst age. أَرْذَلِ الْعُمْرِ. Worst age of his life, and this is the something Allah mentioned to us because it's very important, because it is a very important to every one of us. Why? There is a stage, and we have to know that this stage is the worst stage anyone can imagine. And this stage, everything will change. Everything will change. Your body will be weak, and your mind will be also weak and unwise. And all the people will not accept your behavior. This time is very difficult time. It is very ugly time. It is very frightened times. This time is someone will feel lonely, frightening, disputing stage around it. For this reason, we seek refuge from Allah from that. And what is very important about this ayah, that Allah Azza wa Jal said, minkum. What does that mean? Some of you, not all of you. Because if Allah said, he created you, and he then take you back, and you will go to the worst age, That means all of us. But Allah Azza wa Jal said here, وَمِنْكُمْ. This mean, that means some of you, some of us. Alhamdulillah. It is not all the human will go. Some of you. For this reason, we have to put our plan not to be from those who coming to the worst age in their life. We have to put a plan in all directions. First of all, to ask Allah Azza wa Jal not to be from those people. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was seek refuge to Allah after every prayer from five things. O Allah, I seek refuge in you from to be coward. I seek refuge in you from being sent back to the worst age of the life, and seek refuge in you from trials of this dunya, and seek refuge in you from the suffering of the grave, from the punishment of the grave. These things Rasulullah asked refuge, seek refuge from Allah after every prayer. So, the worst age. First of all, we have to ask Allah not to be in this, not to be in the worst age of our life. Second thing, we have to prepare that time. First of all, if someone didn't educate himself when he is young, he couldn't educate himself when he is old. For this reason, we have to use the time of the youth. We have to use the time of power. We have to use this time to educate ourselves, to train ourselves, to discipline ourselves, to make ourselves familiar with ta'at, with worshipping, with ibadat, with dhikr to Allah Azza wa Jal, with understanding and reciting the Quran. We have to prepare ourselves in all of these when we are strong. Then, when we become old, we were familiar with this. Also, there is very important thing that we shouldn't show off as a human. Oh, I am beautiful. Oh, I am very rich. Oh, I am very strong. Oh, I have a great position. You have to know that there is threaten. There is stage in your time. Maybe you will go to it. So don't be arrogant. So don't be show off. So don't think you are something very great, because sometimes you will be back to be a child, but not in the face of a child, with the face of 100 or 99 person years old. You will be a child in your action, but the action, when someone is a child, you accept it. But when someone is old, you will not accept it. For this reason, we have to avoid any type of show off, any type of be wrongdoing to the people, or to be arrogant. Also, there are many important things to do. As I said, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam ask Allah after every prayer. And this dua exists in the Sahih al-Bukhari. Sahih al-Bukhari mentioned this. Also, Sahih al-Bukhari put special chapter in his book about seeking refuge from the worst time of the life. Ardha lil-umr. To ask Allah to protect you, to protect the people you love from this age, because as I said, this is very difficult age. This is very difficult age to the human and to the people around the human. And also, there are many important things we have to prepare ourselves. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that ليس منا من لم يرحم صغيرنا ويوقر كبيرنا. Rasulullah said that it is not one of us. He is not one of us who doesn't have mercy on our young and doesn't honor our elders. So this adjective, this attitude is very important attitude and very important adjective. And this is how Islam educated the people, educated the new generation, educated the youth to be in respect way. Unfortunately, there are some culture, some society, they don't respect. They don't respect the young, don't respect the old, not in the way of talking, not in the way of acting. He said, he put his leg on the table. What is this? What is this? He shake hands with someone when he is sitting and the other one is standing. What is this? What is this? Is not accepted attitude. For this reason, it is against our religion. It is against the sunnah of the Prophet. The Prophet said, ليس منا, he is not one of us who didn't respect and didn't give the honor to the elders and the one who didn't mercy the young people. It is very great society. This society who take care of the older elders people and who take care of the young people. If we care about these two layers, we will have a happy society. We will have a strong society. We will have respect society. And there is also hadith from Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that ما أكرم شاب شيخا لسنه. No young man honors an old man for his age. No young man honored an old man for his age. But God will appoint someone to honor him in his age. That if you take care of an elder people and help him and serve him, Allah will put someone to take care of you when you become elder. Yes, كما تدين تدان. As you plant, you will get. If you plant onion, you will not get garlic, you will get onion. If you plant tomato, you will take tomato, you will not take potato, of course. So this is, if someone, when he is strong, he don't care about the elder people, he didn't respect them, when he will become elder, also someone will come to him and not respect him. For this reason, ما أكرم شاب شيخا لسنه. No young man honors an old man for his age. Allah will appoint someone to honor him in his age. And this is how you build the strong society. This is how you make the strong society. Also, we have to prepare yourself to this age by taking care of your health, by practicing sport. It is a part Some people think that this is everything. No, it is not. What we mention, it's complete plan. This five words, وَمِنْكُمْ مَنْ يُرَدُّ إِلَىٰ أَرْذَلِ الْعُمُرِ. Some of you will go to the worst age. So, we have to have a plan for these five words. Not to be in this group. Not to be in this age. It's not a matter of age. Look, this point is very important. It doesn't mean that everyone 80, he will go to this, or 90, he will go to this, or no. I met a lot of people, and they are wake up. They're thinking in a nice way, and they are full of barakah. They are full of nur. And if you ask them, they said, we take care of our sins when we were young, and Allah take care of it when we get old. So it's a matter how you use this sense, how you use this power, so this is very important thing for every one of us. As I said, it's not a matter of age, it's a matter of situation. It's a matter of situation. For this reason, we have to care about us. Yani, for instance, one time I have a discussion with a psychiatric doctor. I ask him, when people has depression, it come to them for a few days, and then it pass away. Why they need medicine? He said, yes, they need medicine because if they go to the situation of depression and they didn't take any medicine, this is will make the Alzheimer's disease 3 years becoming to them later. Yani every going in depression situation make the Alzheimer 3 years become later. What does that mean? That mean if you have depression and you take the medicine of depression, this is will make the Alzheimer delay 3 years. Every time you have this depression, really it's very critical. What does that mean? We have to care about the psychological situation. We have to care about body situation. We have to care about health situation. We have to care about our acting towards the other. We have to care our iman and the nur of Allah. Believe me, when someone has the nur of the dhikr, this is will protect him. When someone has the nur of Quran, this is will protect him. And there are some sahaba said that Allah Azza wa Jal protect them because of the Quran. Because of the Quran. Ikrima is one of the great scholar of the Tabi'een. He said, who become closer to Quran, he will not be to the situation of Ardhal al-Umr. He will not be to the situation of the worst time of the age. Maybe you will not listen to this lecture again. This lecture is a lecture for life. This lecture is a lecture for life. And there are many people, they said, oh, we don't know. We don't know this. We don't know that there is something. But Allah warned us. Allah put this ayah in the Quran. Why? Why? For the people who recite the Quran to try to avoid this situation. For the people who read the Quran and understand the Quran to prepare themselves to avoid this situation. May Allah Azza wa Jal give you khair and afiyah. May Allah protect us. And may Allah prevent us to coming to this age. May Allah prevent our people who we love, our people who we know from this age. والحمد لله رب العالمين. الفاتحة. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، وأفضل الصلاة وأتم التسليم على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. اللهم أعنا على ذكرك وشكرك وحسن عبادتك، ولا تجعلنا يا إلهنا يا مولانا من الغافلين. اللهم أرنا الحق حقا وارزقنا اتباعه، وأرنا الباطل باطلا وارزقنا اجتنابه. ربنا لا تزغ قلوبنا بعد إذ هديتنا وهب لنا من لدنك رحمة، إنك أنت الوهاب. سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون، وسلام على المرسلين، والحمد لله رب العالمين. إلى شرف النبي وأرواح المؤمنين. الفاتحة.